Now that you've been able to accomplish basic skills with the derivative after our basic properties, this will focus on the product rule. So the way that we remember the product rule by words is we're going to be identifying what we call the first and the second. And the words are the first times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. Order doesn't matter for this rule. We'll see another rule where it matters, but for this one it doesn't. Now we're going to continue by saying plus the second, so I just rewrite my original second, x to the 1/2 minus 2x to the 3/5 times the derivative of the first. So you may want to pause the video here, go back through, make sure you understand what I've done. But again, the first times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. And lastly, as you continue to study that and understand the pieces there, notice that we do not need to simplify. And here we'll simply continue again. I'm going to underline 7x to the 4th minus x to the 1/3 as my first. And I'm going to underline 2 minus the square root of x as my second. It looks like the only piece that I might want to rewrite is right here. I know that that's x to the 1/2 power. And now I simply start my derivative. M prime of x is going to be equal to the first, I just rewrite it, 7x to the 4th minus x to the 1/3, times the derivative of the second. The derivative of the second, well, we go piece by piece, the derivative of 2 is 0, so it looks like the derivative of the second, this negative out in front is important, right, because that implies that I've got a negative 1 coefficient. So I would bring down my 1/2, multiply it by negative 1, negative 1/2, x to the negative 1/2. But remember, don't stop. That's the first times the derivative of the second. Now we're going to continue with plus the second times the derivative of the first. The derivative of the first, 28 x cubed minus 1/3 x to the negative 2/3. Just to fill in, this would be the second and the derivative of the first. Remember to pause these videos at any point to make sure that you can go back through and agree or figure out some intermediate steps in there that I may have gone over too quickly. For my last example, I wanted to do something a little bit different so that you would understand that some problems might take more than one, product in order to look at the derivative. So what I wanted to show you here, because we only have two pieces in our derivative rule, we need to do grouping a little bit. So I'm going to say that this piece is my first and this piece is my second. So let me go ahead and underline what I see as my first and my second. And then what I want to do now is I start finding the derivative. I want to make sure that I understand that when I say the first times the derivative of the second, that's not going to be the place where I run into trouble. But the second times the derivative of the first is going to be a little bit different there. When I look up here, I only see a couple of places where I might want to rewrite before, and let's go ahead and look at those. I'm thinking that on top right here of the cubed root of a, I know that that's going to be a raised to the 1/3 power. And over here where I have 3 over a, that's going to be minus 3a to the negative 1 power. So my rewrites are there in pink. Now I'm going to start. So the derivative, r prime of a, is going to be my first. So that whole thing that I've represented as my first, I'm just going to rewrite. A squared, a to the 1/3 power, minus 3. That whole piece I'm considering my first, right? Times the derivative of my second. Well, the derivative of 1/4 a is simply 1/4. Here, the derivative of negative 3a to the negative 1, well, when I multiply negative 1 times negative 3, I'm going to get positive 3a to the negative 2. All right, so there's the first. There's the derivative of the second. We're going to continue now by saying plus the second, and the second here, just rewrite it, 1/4 a minus 3a to the negative 1 times the derivative of the first. Now this is where some of you might get a little bit confused, because now I'm going to put brackets. Because within my first, I have two pieces again. So then I would look at this a little bit differently. To take the derivative, now I've got that a squared would be the first, and this little piece would be the second. So remember what I'm doing. This is the second, but now to take the derivative of the first, I need product rule one more time. So I'm going to say the first times the derivative of the second. So that little piece there would simply be 1/3 a to the negative 2/3, because the derivative of negative 3 falls out, plus the second. Plus the second times the derivative of the first. So when you look at this one, the first term was identified as a piece that had a product within it. So when we went through this and needed to go through and take the derivative of the entire function, here you can see the first times the derivative of the second, plus the second, still in good shape, derivative of the first, that involves our product rule again. So please study this and go through, make sure that you understand. If you have questions about any of these, please don't hesitate to contact me. And again, notice, no simplification necessary.